and welcome to the DDOcast, episode 421, recorded live on Sunday, March 13th, 2016. We like to talk about Dungeons & Dragons Online nearly every weekend. You can watch us through Twitch, YouTube, the DDO forums, iTunes, or from our website at ddocast.com. DDOcast is hosted by CyberEars, the awesome podcast hosting network. Shows are usually available within a few days of recording. The next show will be a recorded show and will be released next weekend. You can stay updated by following us on our social media pages or the calendar on our website at ddocast.com. Now, on to the DDOcast Half Hour News Hour.
Good evening. I'm Saba Jade. Patrick Shamgar is away. On the DDOcast Half Hour News Hour tonight, we continue our coverage of 10 years of DDO. Also ahead, gnomes and how they are ruining the game. Plus, Tuber, a taxi service for fighters, clerics, and barbarians. All that and more on tonight's DDOcast Half Hour News Hour. First, a word from one of our sponsors.
Hi, Mora's Mora here, reporting to you live from just outside the Cerulean Hills, where we hope to find more information on CeruleanFarmers.com, a website for lonely Cerulean farmers to find love and hook up and stuff. Excuse me, random person, are you here to answer the call of the wild?
No! You have to help me! Someone has to help me! Lady Asdell has been kidnapped by an Arctime! Those savage orcs are probably torturing important knowledge out of her, like how to read and write, and cure common illnesses, and bathe! You have to save her.
Okay, I have to go stand somewhere else now, like by this bulletin board.
Cerulean farmers only!
Is this like a glee club or something?
CeruleanFarmers.com.
It sure is, little lady. This here's an advertisement for Cerulean farmers to find true love and comfort in a land of desperate loneliness. So far, all the responses we've had are from bugbears, orcs, and vicious feral wolves. We're hoping to cast a wider net this time.
I'd say your net is pretty wide already, Mr. Farmer.
Well, say, you're a sprightly gal. Would you like to come inside and see my farm? Kill most of the rats.
That's okay. I'm in a committed relationship with a very famous Stormreach native, Jeets Shimmis, so I'll pass.
I'm so lonely.
Cool story. Now back to your regularly scheduled news program.
In this week's screenshot, the High Lords of Malkier celebrate the new Deep Gnome. Thanks, Ginger Spice, for sending in this week's screenshot. DDO is celebrating 10 years of DDO. Update 30 features a special anniversary event, free items, and more. Highlights from the 10th anniversary livestream can be found on YouTube. And now, with us from House Fjarlan is Brunhilde, and high over the air in House Caneth is Brittany. Brunhilde, what do you think of 10 years of DDO?
DDO is over! This game is 10 years old! You know what I don't understand? I don't understand why any of you are still playing! In fact, why are you still here? Go home! You! Get out of here! This game is terrible! Unsubscribe!
Shut up, you old bag. DDO is not an old game. It's a well-established game that is progressive, which offers updates and expansions with new content on a regular basis. This game will be around long after your life subscription has been canceled.
Thank you, Brunhilde and Brittany, for your views on the DDO celebration. Rumor has it this will be your last segment for the DDOcast Half Hour News Hour. Good luck at jerryspringer.com. In other news, the DDO data center move. DDO moved the game to a new data center, and with that, the game will be using more ports. If you manually forward your computer's ports for DDO, there's a thread in the forums with a recommended range of ports. For more details on the data center move, we have Mithri and the House Kundaric Bank. Myth?
So, the move happened. The game still works. Awesome. Move on.
In a related story, the devs went on their coffee break about 10 minutes early. I sent a drone to see if we could get early information on the next update. Let's listen in.
Now that I've had French press, I don't think I can go back to automatic drip.
Yeah. Hey, check out my new coffee mug. It says World's Greatest Dev.
That's pretty good. You want a biscotti?
I have some blueberry scones today.
Maybe we should put biscotti and scones in the game.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, not quite the spoilers I had hoped for. While we send that drone back to Houston, let's listen to a local sponsor, Otto's Dance Club.
Otto's Dance Club has arrived. Ladies and male players' dresses, ladies get in free until 10, and all dirty kobolds on tap are half price all night long. That's right, all night long. Because Otto's Dance Club doesn't stop until the music does. Don't know how to dance? No problem. Our bards will give you an irresistible lesson that's tailored just for your race and class. Otto's Dance Club, where you can dance, even if you don't want to.
Mithri, now in House Fjarlin, is going to tell us about this week's bonus days. Mithri?
Thanks, Saberjay. 1 second. I need to put on the wellies I just purchased here in the erstwhile Emporium. It's so wet over here, I don't want to get my shoes wet. DDO bonus days bring you no new bonus event, Treasure Hunters Weekend, now through March 13th. Here's how it works. Treasure dice rolls are increased by 10, making it more likely that you will get maximum effects on loot.
That sounds pretty nice, Myth. So I'll get a better chance at named loot then?
No, this doesn't increase your chance to get named loot.
Better end reward?
No, this only affects chests, not end rewards.
Okay, so what does it do?
Well, first it stacks with Treasure Hunter elixirs. This is a separate bonus from traditional loot bonuses, which raise the level of the chest. This raises the chance to get good stuff for the level of the chest you're opening. A loot bonus will raise the level of the chest, and a Treasure Hunter's Elixir will increase the chance to get lucky loot from the chest. So combining both together will have an impact.
Okay, a little bit confusing. Thank you, Mithri.
The DDO Chronicle improperly called this a 20% bonus. Apologies for the error. It's actually a plus 10 bonus.
Thank you, Mithri, and try and stay out of the rain. Now Lessa will tell us about this week's store news.
Thank you very much, Sabajay's. I'm happy to tell everyone about the store news. March 11th through 17th. The sales are 20% off True and Lesser Hearts of Wood, 20% off Quest XP, 20% off Healing Items, and 20% off Spell Point Potions. Get in line, get your Spell Point Potions while supplies last.
Okay.
Your free sample... The free sample of the week, 5 Lasting Potions of Resist Fire. 1 per account, though, so choose wisely.
Is there a coupon code for that, Lessa?
There is a coupon code for that. It will be posted in the show notes, but if you have a pen and you want to jot it down, it's 6GUMMED11YALLAW07.
Usually the coupon codes mean something. Any guesses on that one, Lessa?
I think it has something to do with paladins and mud.
Very good. And I think that sales, we know some sorcerer who's going to get a bunch of spell point pots. What do you think?
I think so, too. One
All
or
right.
two.
Yay!
In this week's community news, Ginger Spice is starting a new video series looking at the Deep Gnome. We'll take a closer look at the gnomes later in the program. Also, DDO Players News interviews Nick from the Shady Rogues, and the MM Motivational Thread on the DDO forums has entered the Hall of Fame. If you would like to nominate a player for the community spotlight, email ddo@turbine.com with the subject line Player Spotlight. Now we go back to Mithri, who will tell us about this week's events.
Events. I love events. The High Lords of Malkier are hosting an epic Vault of Night teaching raid on Saturday. I think that's great. Guildhall. The Explorers of Thalanus are one of the server's most active guilds and are looking for players of all skills and gameplay styles. The guild features adult players who work together and have drama-free fun. Find Double Dump on Thalanus to join them. DUBBLEDUMP. And if you want to have your guild featured, send an email to ddo@turbine.com with the subject line Guild Hall. The Chronicle comment, why does Bold still hate you. Comment on the forums and win turbine points. There will be two winners selected on the 22nd, and the Chronicle's taking a week off, so they'll see you in 2 weeks.
Thanks, Mithri. Some interesting events there. Those Hive Lords are busy, aren't they? First screenshot of the week, and now a teaching raid.
No kidding.
Myth, what do you think about teaching raids? I've heard you say you'd like to join a Vaughn teaching raid, or at least do it the non-Zerging way.
I think they're great. I would love to join that teaching raid, but I don't have anybody big enough level on that server to do it. But every time I go into Vaughn's 5, I feel a little bit lost. Seems like everybody else knows what they're doing, and I just sort of stand there and collect XP.
Well, perhaps they do a video of it. You could follow the Twitch stream.
Oh, that would be nice.
And you said the Explorers of Philanus are a drama-free guild? Do you think that's possible, to be drama-free?
Oh, well, I'm a little skeptical, but I wasn't going to say anything.
All right, and for the Chronicle comment, let's get all our reporters' opinions. Myth, why does Kobold still hate you?
I actually know the answer to this. One day, I was in the harbor, and a kobold named Mr. Greasix came up to me and said, "You want to know why kobolds still hate you?" And I said, "No, not really." And he said, "Okay, I'll tell you. Remember the time when you were level 20 and you went into kobold assault and laid down so many firewalls that all 200 kobolds died, and then 200 more just before the side of the building you were standing in caved in? That's why kobolds still hate you." And I said, "Well, okay, thanks for the info."
Lessa, what about you? Why does Kobold still hate you?
Well, this is a very scientific answer. Kobolds are short, like halflings, making them naturally inferior. They are cursed with a lot of genetic hurdles that they'll never be able to jump over, even with the amazing Kobold jump ability. So sorry, but not sorry, Kobolds. I don't care that you hate me.
And roving reporter Bill?
You see, kobolds are petty creatures who think of themselves as sharing a lineage with dragons. It's because of this draconic Napoleon complex that they're so spiteful. Did you know that Drizzafrabadoo roughly translates to die, fleshy meatbag?
Before the fansite news, do you need pain relief? Try Cryptmoss Infusion.
If you're suffering from too many aches and pains after your next big fight, there's no reason for you to suffer needlessly. Ask your cleric about Cryptmoss Infusion. Cryptmoss Infusion can restore health, heal moderate wounds, and recharge your energy levels. It's the number one recommended pain reliever in the marketplace. During a testing study, some patients reported stomach cramps, diarrhea, and a temporary loss of memory. In most cases, side effects were mild to moderate. Discontinue the use of Cryptmoss Infusion if you are rerolling or thinking of rerolling. Cryptmoss Infusion is not intended for use by some races, including Warforged. Ask your cleric if Cryptmoss Infusion is right for you. Reclaiming your health bar has never been easier. It means reclaiming your freedom. So the next time you are charred by a scorching ray, wounded by acid splash, or magic missile, remember, health is just an infusion away.
Lessa, any fansite news this week?
Absolutely, Saba, there's some fansite news. Let's talk about it. DDO Cast walks through Spies in the House this week. DDO Players talks about the data center move, the latest D&D news. I bet they wish they had spy drones in the turbine break room. Also, DDO Gamer writes about the anniversary event, and the Damsels of DDO study the Sable Mansion in their latest podcast. I wouldn't listen to them if I were you. I heard they were a bunch of show-stealing hacks who can't even be bothered to follow directions when the DDO cast takes a week off. Also, in the news, Nomos Entertainment explains many of the NPCs and mini-bosses in the new anniversary dungeon. And even notes Mechanic Rogue solos the Shroud. She's unstoppable, folks. Erdrick crunches the numbers on the Monster Manual. Go to the Fansite News for a link to the charts and graphs. And finally, Shady Rogues continue their trek through the Sorrow Dusk Island. Go watch it. Just don't watch it right now, because you're listening to the DDO Cast, Half Hour News Hour. And that's the Fansite News. I'm Lessa, and you're not.
Thank you, Lessa. Still
you're
to
welcome.
Come on the DDO Cast News Hour, gnomes and deep gnomes, why? And Tuber, a new taxi service. First up, the Fashion Report, brought to you by Mithri Inferno.
Hi. It's Mithri Inferno with the Fashion Report. I've been scouting all the shops in the marketplace and the auction house for the hottest new styles of robes in Stormreach. Over the past few weeks, it's been a disappointing line of droopy sashes, pointed shoulders, and overstuffed backpacks. But today, I'm happy to report that I've finally found the perfect outfit. The neckline is delicately trimmed with fairy lace imported from...
Excuse me, but I'm going to be needing that.
Needing what?
That outfit. See, I've been spending a lot of time in the mind of Jeets, trying to really learn what makes him tick, and I discovered that he loves drinking and gambling and other women. But there's one surefire way I have to get his attention. I'm going to be a damsel in distress.
Excuse me? You mean a damsel in distress?
Mm-hmm.
Nobody is wearing this dress, least of all you. I haven't even worn it yet.
No, I need it more than you. Now, give it up.
Back off, shorty.
No, I want
you can't
it.
Wear this. It won't fit me when I get it back. Stop it!
Jeets will love me if it's the last thing I do.
You're going to rip it. I'm a sorcerer.
And now, a word from our sponsor. Wait, we have another sponsor?
Whether it's raining from the skies thanks to some demented anniversary cake genie or pulled from a forgotten chest at the end of a hard day's questing, tasty ham is definitely riches beyond understanding. Baked, grilled, flame-struck, firewalled, or sunbursted, it has the texture and delicious salty twang you could trick a pig into eating. Some folks say it's a blight on Stormreach, but they haven't had it cooked up right and served with a side of applesauce. So next time you get tired of meat as red as rust monster, giant spider, or beef, carve yourself up some tasty ham, the other white meat, somewhere between chicken and giant scorpion. Gargon knows people who don't eat tasty ham, but he's not sure he trusts them.
For our first news story, Bill Gasarme takes to the streets to ask about the fighter class.
This is Gnome reporter Bill Gasarme coming to you live from Stormreach, reporting on the death of the fighter class. As we all know, the fighter is dead. The class has been replaced by barbarians, paladins, and even swashbuckling bards. Kentank circles around the fighter. For reactions, we go to the average Stormreach citizen. Excuse me, sir. Do you have an opinion on the fighter class? Sir? Sir? Come back. You must be in a hurry. Let me try another. Ma'am, what is your opinion on the fighter? Is the fighter class...
But I don't know you. Get away from me. Get away, young man. Help! Help! Stormreach guard, help! Where's the purple dragonite when you need one? Dang, I got off that tuber in the wrong place. Help! Help!
Okay. I think I'll just move over here and try someone else. You, sir, hail and well met. You seem to be well armored. Are you a fighter?
Well, hello to you too, smaller than average person. That's right. I am a fighter.
So, Mr. Fighter, how does it feel to be obsolete?
Excuse me?
Obsolete, no longer useful.
I'm sorry, you must be mistaken.
So then, what makes you so special?
Well, besides being devilishly handsome...
You, aside over here...
Fan club.
Meet you back at my place in an hour.
Be gone, Temptress, I'm trying to conduct an interview.
Hey, I'm a fighter. It's true. Barbarians can fight. Paladins can fight if you're into that sort of thing. And yes, swashbucklers can fight, but are they a fighter? No. I'll give you this, little fella. I can stun you. I can stunning shield you, and I can run you over and knock you down. And then send you crying home to your freakishly small gnomish family. So go back to your garden, gnome.
And there you have it. Back to you, Saba.
Thanks, roving reporter Bill, and welcome to the DDO Cast Half Hour News Hour. An excellent first report. Not sure what to see at the theater this week? Check out this movie trailer for Gnome Alone.
In the not-so-distant future, in a time of candy canes and festival twigs, a raid group has just completed their greatest quest.
Well, guys, I was skeptical when DDO said Module 27 would include time travel, but you know what? They really pulled it off. Well, that trans-temporal window was sweet.
And that's why DDO is still the number one MMO after 16 years.
So, I'm finishing out. It seems like there's something we forgot.
What are you talking about? We got Ransack, Conquest, Karma, Psionics. What could we have forgotten?
Kevin!
This festival, one player character is stuck in the past, battling to save Stormreach. Kevin is Gnome Alone.
I have to stop the Stravorath invasion without letting anybody see me. I couldn't wait till they change the history of the game. I'll just paint some red symbols around the marketplace. Oh, and I'm a gnome, so the doll makes sense.
Coming to the Livewood Theater this festival, seating is limited.
By my calculations, this bazaar tent should just barely be able to withstand a level 23 chakra storm. Oh, crap.
This film is rated G for Gnome.
And now Les's report on gnomes and deep gnomes, should they be in the game.
Thank you very much, Saba. Gnomes and iconic deep gnome wizards were introduced as a playable class with Update 30. They get +2 to intelligence, making them a prime artificer and wizard candidates, and a -2 to strength and carrying capacity that equates to a bologna sandwich and a bag of marbles. Congratulations, Turbine. You've taken us all back to the 6th grade circa 1987. As an objective news reporter, I have just one question. Why? Gnome, go home.
You gotta love a gnome. They are so little and sweet and cute. I just little pits their little cheeks.
So small, you mean? I can't even see them any better than halflings. And when clerics throw their heels chest high, some of those little gnomes are gonna drop like flies when the heels fly right over their heads. Plus, they have these little tiny doors on their houses, and that ensures that I will never be invited in, ever. So no dinner for me.
We have plenty of room in Stormreach for little gnome homes. They won't take up much room at all.
It's time to name the smallest elephant in the room, folks. Gnomes are snobs. Pure and simple.
And they're smart, too.
Great work, Lessa, highlighting the anti-gnome sentiment now pervading the game. In a related story, rumor has it that damsels of DDO are going to make level 7 gnomes. For our next story, Mithri talks about Tuber.
Thanks, Saba. Since the beginning of time, players have been complaining about having to run to a quest. It's too far. I can't find it. Well, as usual, the nice folks at Turbine have heard your requests. Along with airships and house teleporters, there will soon be a taxi service. Yes, Lazy Bones, a taxi to take you from quest door to quest door. The rumor is that the taxi will be called Tuber. I'm not sure about that, but maybe. And will only be available to clerics, barbarians, and fighters. So basically, any class that can cast aside from healers will be persona non grata. Each ride will cost the traveler 2K plat one way. There's talk about having quest package deals, so far only one-way trips are planned. You'll be able to summon a taxi from pretty much anywhere outside in a public area, and yes, even in Evening Star, since the taxis are covered wagons pulled by oxen. Taxi tokens will be sold for plat by vendors throughout Stormreach and Evening Star, and will probably be available in the DDO store eventually. Just click on a token, and then select your quest ride from a menu, and you will be whisked away through the city directly to your destination. Don't worry, all you casting classes. I'm sure a proper rant or four on the forums will sway the powers that be, and all the classes will eventually be added to the roster.
Tuber is the greatest thing ever for us fighter classes. I mean, we're already in great shape, right? Because of all the fighting and the running everywhere. We don't need to run more. What we need is to get to the quest store as fast as possible so that we can get our XP. This means less time waiting and more killing. So thanks, Tuber.
Oh, give me a break. Tuber's a terrible idea. No one will ever learn where they're going, and those fighters think they're in great shape. Well, maybe they are now, but if they start taking a cart to every quest, they won't be in shape for long. Really, do you want a bunch of fat fighters and barbarians waddling around in a quest with you? It'll be like a bunch of cops at a donut convention.
Thank you, Mithri, for that insightful, yet biased report on the new Tuber service. Next up, Lessa has an editorial about crafting. Lessa?
Oh boy, do I. Ever. So, crafting is back. Oh, wait.
it isn't. No, not really.
But you can break things down, right? That's great. I love the satisfying sound of the coffee grinder in the morning. My gaming day isn't complete without a visit to the crafting hall. I didn't realize how much I missed it until I had it back, quite honestly. Was losing the ability to use the crafting hall a nuisance? Yes, absolutely. Did I die a little each day when I couldn't break down my loot? Yes. Yes, I did. So thank you very much, Turbine, for letting me get back to gaining teeny tiny bits of crafting XP for breaking down my loot. Also, just like the kobolds, I still hate you. Lessa, remember what you did when you broke crafting. Oh, I'm sorry, wait, you think this is a joke, right? This is not a joke. Give crafting some love. I mean it. I don't forgive easily, and my memory is long. This relationship between me and you is still broken. Fix it, or I will make you suffer.
Thank you, Lessa. I'm a little bit afraid to go on with our next editorial, but here's Mithri with a story about lag. Mithri?
Lag. I'm so tired of hearing people blame everything on lag. I died because it lagged. Ugh. I think I've had lag about 3 times in the past 2 years. Maybe you should stop blaming Turbine and take a look at your equipment. If you are hearing the bing-bong of a modem right before you connect to the game, you might think about an upgrade. If you're still trying to decide if it's worth getting that expensive Pentium, you should probably get an upgrade. If your video card doesn't have its own fan...
Mithri, don't you think this strategy of blaming the victim is a
Shut
little...
Shut up, Lessa.
Okay, then.
Well, if any of this applies to you, then you should go get some better equipment and stop blaming Turbine. Your lack of purchasing a quality PC is not their problem and most likely reason you're lagging.
Wow, somehow I knew that was a mistake to have another editorial. I do apologize, citizens of Stormreach. That's it for tonight's DDOcast Half Hour News Hour. Hit us up at DDOcast.com for show notes, MP3s, our calendar, previous shows, swag, and other fun stuff.
Hang on.
Yes?
I have one more thing to say.
Okay.
Turbine, fix the cold spells.
Fine. Want to be part of the show? Have a comment on this episode? Have a question you'd like to hear us answer? Or a topic you'd like us to debate? Or just want to say hi? Leave a comment or email us at ddocast@gmail.com. You can also find us on social media and follow us for the latest cast updates. Join DDOcast next week for a pre-recorded show. Probably more like what you are used to hearing at this time. We'll end this week's show with a word from our other sponsor. Thank you for listening. So, until next time, may all your attack rolls be crits and all your chest levels appropriate. Have fun and don't forget to play DDO.
Could switching to Smyco really save you 15% or more on airship insurance? Does a former House Deneath drill sergeant make a terrible enchanter?
And that's why Yellow Scorching Ray made Kobold sad! Kobold thinks...
That's interesting! You know what makes me sad? You do! Maybe we should chug on over to Corthone's Island where we can find you a little self-confidence, you jackwagon! Turbo Crystal! Crybaby.
Schmyco, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.